प्लीज।
गुड इवनिंग मैडम प्रिंसिपल डॉक्टर विदिशा घोष दोस्तदार, ऑनरेबल स्पीकर डॉक्टर शुक्ला हाथा, प्रिंसिपल ईस्ट कलकत्ता गर्ल्स कॉलेज, पार्टिसिपेंट्स, कोलीग्स एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम महुआ बासु, द IQSE कोऑर्डिनेटर ऑफ मणिपुर महिला महाविद्यालय, एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस वेबिनार दैट हैज बीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ज्योग्राफी in collaboration with IQSE Manipur Mohila Mahavidyalaya on climate change and harmful. I request Madam Principal Dr. Vidisha Ghosh Dostidar to please give the welcome address. Madam.
Thank you. Do you hear me? Thank you.
Yes, Madam.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Professor Mohua Basu. Good evening. Welcome to today's state-level webinar on climate change and AMFUL. I welcome Dr. Shukla Hajra, Principal of East Calcutta Girls College, on behalf of the teachers, students and non-teaching staffs of Manipur Mohila Mahavidyalaya. She is an inspiration to us, not inspiration, she is the role model to us. I feel proud and happy to welcome her as the speaker in today's webinar. Scientists are discovering complex relationship between anthropological activities and climate change. For example, it is observed that higher rate of air pollution causes higher frequency of cyclones to be generated. Roxy Matthew Cole, eminent meteorologist, commented, "Our research shows that high ocean temperatures are conducive for rapid intensification of cyclones in the North Indian Ocean. High surface temperature in Bay of Bengal could change a cyclone or charge a cyclone as tropical cyclones primarily draw their energy from evaporation at the ocean surface. Global warming is leading to an increase in the heat content of the upper oceans around the globe. Due to lockdown, heat absorbing aerosols such as black carbon had decreased significantly in atmosphere, and that heat being absorbed by surface water of oceans made it hotter to form cyclones like AMFUL. Now, how will we be aware of this situation and how can we avoid such disasters? Let us hear from Dr. Hajra. Now, I request Professor Mohu to please start.
Thank you, Madam. Before we go into the technical session, I would like to inform everyone that this webinar has garnered much interest among many people. However, we have not been able to accommodate them here. That is why this webinar is being telecast live on YouTube. The link for live telecast is being posted in the chat box of Google Meet. Please share it with all your friends who are unable to join the webinar directly. They can watch it live on YouTube. The link for YouTube Live has already been posted in the chat box. Thank you. Now, I request Professor Laboni Sarkar, Faculty, Department of Geography, Manipur Mohila Mahavidyalaya, to please take over the session.
A very good evening to all. At the very outset, I would like to thank to our respected Principal Madam Dr. Vidisha Ghosh Dostidar, Manipur Mohila Mahavidyalaya, and our respected IQSE Coordinator Madam Professor Moha Basu for giving me the opportunity to introduce our respected speaker Dr. Shukla Hajra in this webinar. Today, the topic of our webinar is climate change and AMFUL. In the recent days, we are going through a very tough period. The pandemic has caused a severe change in the life of common people. During this time, we have to shifted our classroom from physical to digital one. Apart from this, the tropical cyclone Amphan has played a devastated role in West Bengal. Along with pandemic situation, this Amphan has tremendously affected the life of the people. So, on behalf of the Department of Geography, this topic has been chosen for this webinar. Now, it's a matter of pride and pleasure for us to introduce Dr. Shukla Hajra, principal of East Calcutta Girls College, and here is a brief biodata of her. Dr. Shukla Hajra is principal of East Calcutta Girls College, Lake Town, Kolkata, under West Bengal State University. She has completed her PhD in 1988 from University of Calcutta. Dr. Hajra has more than 30 years of teaching experiences at the undergraduate and postgraduate level. She specializes in application of remote sensing, digital image processing, urbanization, environmental degradation, sustainable development, food security, poverty studies. Till now, she has ample number of books, both as author and editor, and more than 50 research publications. At present, 5 PhD students are pursuing their research under her supervision, and 2 PhD students are already awarded. She is one of the pioneers among the academicians on GIS mapping, on studies in GIS, who undertook advanced training on GIS mapping at Laval University, Canada in 1992. Now, it's over to Madam. Thank you, Madam.
Okay, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good evening, everybody. I must thank Professor Bidisha Ghosh Dostidar, principal of Banipur Mahavidyalaya, and Professor Mohua Basu, IQAC coordinator of the college, to invite me and give me opportunity to say a few words on climate change and Amphan. This is a lockdown period. Of course, we are confined in our room and we are always suffering from some mental pain, that whether there is some attack or not. But within this period, as an educationist or as a teacher, we are going always with our teaching and learning process. There are many, many difficulties in this period, but I must say that in this period only, we can arrange our webinar in the evening. We always arrange our seminar in the daytime, but now we switch our time of teaching and learning from the morning to evening with some break or some interval. So the teachers and students who are well connected with each other, they are doing their good work within this period. My topic is today is climate change and Amphan. Dr. Ghosh Dostidar, she in brief says the important points of climate change. This climate change is very important today, and I must say from 1992, from Kyoto Protocol, when people started, mainly UN started to think about the carbon emission. With the development of urban areas or with advancement of industrial development, urbanization, the most important thing, it is seen that there is a huge carbon emission in the industries and also from the urban areas. So I first share my PowerPoint presentation here, and then I will continue my lecture. Okay. Okay. Is the screen?
Yes, ma'am, your screen is visible.
Visible, okay. Okay, thank you very much.
Ma'am, can you please click on this hide option?
Which one?
Hide option, ma'am.
Hide option. Means, where it is hide option? It is not visible?
Ma'am, it is visible, but there is a short dialog box.
Short dialog box, but it is not rectangular. Here on my screen.
Beside the blue label in the dialog box.
Just click on the hide beside the stop sharing. Kingshuk Mondol, please stop screen presentation.
Okay. Is it okay now?
Kingshuk Mondol.
Remove Kingshuk Mondol. Remove him.
Okay. Is it okay now?
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely fine, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. So I start with a picture. This is a picture of Amphoon and it is Calcutta. So I must say that with Dr. Ghosh Dostidar, Vidisha Ghosh Dostidar, that Amphoon is not a single one. It is actually going on in several names in last many years. And what are the causes? The first thing I go to the preliminary part. This is a wind system, that is the equatorial low where it is hot and the wind come here from subtropical lows and heat goes back here. So the wind goes up and it comes down. This is the sail where it is formed in the atmosphere. These are called Hadley cell. I am not discuss these things. I must go to these intertropical convergence zone. That equator, along the equator, the low pressure is not constant. It shifted towards north along with the shifting of the sun in the month of July, maximum northwards, and in the month of December, it is maximum southward. Why it is so important? Because India is located in these shifting areas. Tropical, intertropical convergence zone, low pressure belt, it goes upwards in the month of July. So it gives the path of the or the way of the southeast trade wind to enter here into across the equator and then it rides to turn. So it bears a lot of moisture and causes rainfall in the month of July and August. I said in brief, there are so many theories, but this is the situation. Because we are very near India, I just emphasize on India. It is very near to 0 degree, or 8 degree is only the southernmost part. And on the north, there is, we know, Himalayas. And this is the intertropical convergence zone line. So these plays an important role. Now I must say about the climate change. What happens? I must say that global annual average surface temperature is increasing. I here mention only the situations. Next, I will explain why these situations occurring. Ocean heat content is increasing. Atmospheric concentrations of carbon dioxide is increasing. Global mean sea level is going up. Changing extent or mass of cryosphere means solid ice, that is mean Arctic and Antarctic, and global precipitation, its distribution, its amount, all are changing. So these are the changes here I actually addressed. Due to climate change, what happened? Why we are very much aware of this climate change? Climate change causes the increase of vulnerability. What is vulnerability? Vulnerability refers to the degree to which people or things they value are susceptible to. Othoba ami bolte pari je je somosto manushera ebong tader je somosto sompod seta agricultural land or their houses or urban areas, there are the adverse impact of climate, there are the adverse impact of climate, it becomes vulnerable. Vulnerability means exposure, sensitivity, and adaptivity. If the people have less adaptivity, jodi jotota exposure tader hocche, if the temperature increases, it affects agriculture. If the temperature increases, it affects human health. If the temperature increases, it affects the groundwater or the evapotranspiration. And so there is a limit. We know there is a limit because we the people like to stay not below temperature 10 degrees and not above temperature 40 degrees. So we are more comfortable between 15 degrees to 30 degrees. And from 15 degrees to 10 degrees, if it becomes 5 degrees, then 0 degree, we need some extra protection. Similarly, when the temperature goes up above 35 degree, 40 degree, or 45 degree, 50 degree, then we need some protections also, like air cooler or air conditioner. So heating and air conditioner, use for their comfortable for zone. Vulnerability, if the vulnerability take a climate change, we say the previous one that the mean sea level rises. We say that the carbon dioxide concentration increases. Then it causes the health issue. It causes the drowning of the cities, which are very near to ocean, and also the melting of the ice in these areas of Arctic and Antarctic, which are mainly the habitat of the polar animals, and they become extinct. So they become vulnerable to this situation. If we think about the types of hazard which occur due to climate change, there are many hurricane, typhoons, cyclones. These are all named, all are tropical cyclones. In some countries, it is called, and also it also depends on the speed also. It is typhoons, hurricane, cyclone, and also there are floods. There are extreme high temperature resulting drought, wildfire, and also landslide due to huge rainfall. So these are all actually causes the hazard. And when it causes hazard, then we feel that they are vulnerable. These red zone, they are severely non-resilient. Means they are not able to withstand the climate change. These people, we know Vidarbha, every year we know about Vidarbha, the agriculture failed in this region. Ei jaygay lokera kebol agriculture er upor depend kore. Sutrang ei somosto in this region, when there is a change of 1 or 2 degrees of climate, temperature rises for 1 or 2 degrees, then the people, the crop failure occurs in this region. Agriculture is our important production or important economy. So temperature or climate is our most important concern, and climate change affects our economy, our livelihood. And it causes the disaster. Disaster means that it causes the functioning of community or a society disruption. In the functioning of the production, there is a disruption of the production. There is the disruption of the insufficient material or insufficient support. When people, they get insufficient support, there is the vulnerability results, and disaster affects the people. So I just give you the one thing. This is the Kendrapara district of Odisha of India. And these are the, nowadays we can get information on the flood, cyclone, drought, and the microwave remote sensing radar image or Landsat image, we can get the data daily. We know about the satellites which are moving, and they are capturing data. We can analyze the data, and the thing which we can see that 18 September 2008, the rainfall starts after 2 days, 20th September. This is 22nd September. So the land totally covered or flood occurs here. And on the other side, if you go just after 3 or 4 months, the people are waiting for few drops of water. So Maharashtra is suffering from drought, Odisha is suffering from cyclone, Bengal is suffering from cyclone, not only cyclone, also drought occur, agricultural droughts occur in western part of West Bengal. So in India, several types of hazards or disaster occurred due to floods or due to drought, and why, and these are going to occur day by day in higher magnitude. This is US coastal area where people are thinking that only 1 meter or 2 meters increase of water resulting the inundation of the area and vulnerable. These are the vulnerable area of sea level rise. Then I must say about the climate risk index. What is the climate risk index? We must define that there are different types of hazard. I already mentioned that there are different types of hazard. And we first define the hazard. What is the hazard? Is it urban flood, or is it coastal flood, or it is drought or landslide? And we have to identify the affected area. Then we have to assess the damage due to that hazard or disaster, and then we calculate the risk of the exposure to that hazard. So if we see that Africa is totally is very risky zone, and these areas, the Mongolia and all these Central Asia, these are hazardous. These area, Norway and Sweden and Britain, this is a high risk zone because the melting of these Arctic water. So there are many kinds of climate risk index calculation and global climate risk index analysis that the different regions of the world are going to the risk conditions. This is a global mean sea level rise, and if we see that from 1880 to 2010, there is a gradual increase of the rise of sea level. So this is the time last 200 years. This is the time of urbanization all over the globe, and this is the time of industrialization and carbon emission and continuous land use and land cover changes, which causes these situations and the rise of ocean level, which results if the ocean levels rises. If only 2 meter rise of ocean may result 2 to 3 meter rise of ocean level results, may the drowning of Calcutta city like other cities in all over the world. So we must be careful about the sea level rise. Every year it goes up 1 or 2 centimeter. We are thinking that it is only centimeter, but centimeters makes meter. So we will lose all this civilization. And this is a very known picture in Arctic, where polar bear is standing only on a piece of ice, and it melts. And if it is going on, it results the extinction of this type of. Polar bear. And this is, we know that the extreme sea level, all the sea level, this part this is British Isles, British Isles, England, and the northern parts and the northern parts of North America. All these coastal red marks, it is under high threat because the polar ice, Arctic ice, are melting at a faster rate. Similarly, in the north southern part, these are red marks because of the melting ice from Antarctica. This is Alaska. So we are seeing that the Arctic and subarctic regions are mainly at high risk zone. This is, you see, that is Mumbai. It is Mumbai 1.5 meter high. This region goes gradually. It is a land. Now it is gradually going under the water. It is Vietnam. Vietnam, after 50 years, and now after 30 years, it grows gradually under the water from the South China Sea. Also, we are seeing that most of the people are affected by rising sea level. Our India and Korea, Vietnam, and these Borneo, Java, Sumatra, all these Burma, all these Southeast and South Asia, and also Central Asia and coastal part, including Japan, and are at high risk zone because of the in this region nearly 10 to 50 million people are inhabiting in this region.
Ma'am, sorry, ma'am, to interrupt you, but your audio is mute, ma'am. Someone has muted you, ma'am. Please unmute yourself, ma'am.
Bonojit Sarkar has muted, madam.
Participants, please do not mute the speaker. Ma'am, you are not audible, ma'am. Please unmute yourself.
Someone muted me.
Yes, ma'am. Now you're audible, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Sorry, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
So this is the situation where we have seen that our highly dense populated areas, if the rise of sea level occurs, there are a huge number of population, 10 to 15 million populations are affected due to rise of the sea level. Though the risk zone is here high, but Norway, Sweden, or Alaska, this region is inhabited by lesser number of population. So we are at high risk zone. Next is, if we see the temperature condition, if you see Delhi, it is in 1968, the temperature and from India cities are getting hotter days. How many days they are getting hotter? 1350 to 14, from 1959 to 68, 1350 to 209 to 10 in 1 year, 350 to 465 days. So means almost the number of days are increasing within 2 years. It is 200 days per year. Temperature that city is hotter. In case of Mumbai, Kolkata also, it gets hotter. It is at 440 days in 2 years. And also in Chennai, it is also that from 1000 to 1600 means 300. Nearly the whole day, whole year, 300 days out of 365, it is hotter. So the temperature is increasing at a very faster rate, and the temperature causes the unhealthy condition. we are saying that we feel discomfort. What is discomfort? It is also calculated. It is known as death. It is known as discomfort index. The temperature, we are saying that temperature is 35, but we feel like 45 degrees. What is that? Actually, when there is a relative humidity is high, the temperature in relative humidity means water vapor means water plus heat, that is called latent heat. So with temperature 35 degree, if relative humidity is 90%, so there is a huge amount of latent heat which is added to that, and people feel like 40-42 degrees Celsius. So it is that it causes the discomfort, and discomfort index is going higher, and temperature due to increasing temperature, and when the temperature increases, its water holding capacity increases, it holds much more vapor. So when the water vapor total amount, absolute amount is increasing, relative humidity is also increased, and also latent is increased, this results the discomfort index. So next one is the drought. Drought is actually the common occurrence in India. I am already mentioned that in the northern northwestern part, especially Maharashtra and Rajasthan, drought is an important phenomena, and climate change is expected to alter the frequency and magnitude of drought. The drought, if it is for 1 month, it is handled by someone in some ways. But if it continues for 2 months, 3 months, if the frequency of drought is increasing, magnitude is increased, dry land regions are disappropriate at risk. We know that they are practicing the dry land farming, but if the it continues for a long time, dry land farming is not even possible. And of the net zone area of India, 68% of the region of the land is drought prone, and now 33% in chronically drought prone area. We know about that irrigation system. We try to change this situation, but what happened? With the help of the big dam, there is control of the river and the natural flow is not flowing naturally. So there is the accumulation of sediment, which results in the death of river, and it causes the flood on the embankment on the valley of the river. So the major impact is that there is a deficit of rainfall due to higher temperature, urbanization. There is a deficit of underground water recharge due to urbanization, and shortfall of this type of rainfall causes the lowering of the underground water table. So this is I give you a satellite imagery analysis from 1973 to 2009 of Bangalore city of India. Please see the red part are the urban areas and the green part are the vegetative areas. From 1973, if you look, it is 1973, then 1992, then 2000, 2006 and 2009. So what happened? These red parts are the built-up area. What is the effect on the climate? There is a huge effect on microclimate of this built-up area. If there is a built-up area, there is the urban heating, which we are called urban heat island. I will discuss it about high urban heat island. And not only that, it created an impervious area. In any built-up area, means in any city, the land is covered with the impervious pavements and roads and buildings. So the rainfall cannot penetrate in the soil. But human beings, they withdraw the underground water for their use. So temperature increases, surface temperature increases, and it creates a microclimate on the city, and it results the huge also the rise in surface temperature. In the if this is surface temperature is also getting higher and higher. It is London, not only in India, it is London. You see, it is London, it is Jakarta. So these are all, the whole world is towards urbanization. And urban in Thailand actually is that urban areas where the temperature is at least 2 degrees higher than the suburban or surrounding rural areas. So if you see this small diagram, this is the urban areas, the temperature is higher, and the rural and areas or suburban areas, if there are the vegetative cover, there the temperature is comparatively lower. So what happened? This is actually happened. The solar radiation, it heated this brick structure, and when it radiates back, it is trapped. When the end, it becomes a trapping of these heat here, outgoing temperature. Incoming solar radiation heated these buildings, and the hill this building radiated back the temperature, but it is trapped and it becomes hotter and hotter. So if there are higher buildings and the space between two buildings are not enough, these buildings are always getting hot, and the people, they feel discomfort index, discomfort. So this is the situation. You see that if it is open surface, the temperature, the solar radiation, it reflects back to the space. It comes, it reflects back from the open surface, or from the ice, from the vegetative cover, they reflect it back to the space. But in the cities, they absorb the heat, they release the heat, and when they release the heat, it actually results the trapping of this heat within themselves, and it gets hotter and hotter. That's why urban areas become a heat island. That's why it is saying that this is the urban, it results microclimate, separate type of microclimate. Sometimes we have seen in the city areas that during the daytime, it is high, temperature is very high, and if there are the water bodies surrounding it, it accumulates some vapor, and at the evening, like equatorial region, there is the rainfall occurs, because this is a microclimate which created this due to the temperature changes in the city region than the surrounding region. Next, I go to the land use and land cover change. This one, this is the Bhortir bill in different times. These images are analyzed. That is, one is, it is in 2001, 2002, and 2015 and 16. 2001, in pre-monsoon period, that accumulation of water is here, and this is the agricultural land. In the post-monsoon period, the water covered most of the areas. This is 2001 and just after 15 years, the 2015 and 16, the only the water is in this part. It is means the other parts are actually their settlement, or the urban built-up area started, and agriculture started, and the only one part is the wetland. So wetland, this is a total wetland reduced to this small size. What is the role of wetland? What is the impact of the change of this land use on the climate? The change of the changing role of the wetland is that wetland is acts like a sponge. It absorbs the water and it recharges the groundwater, and maintain the climate smoother and cooler. But when the water bodies become shorter or smaller, then the absorption or the recharging of the groundwater or the maintenance of the temperature all are disturbed. So the land use change is also disturbed our climate. This is actually, elevation with the risk zone is along east coast of India. It is Calcutta. These are high risk zone because these are here the storm surges, and when it surges, it goes up to the northern part. It is including Bangladesh. It one way the tropical storm surges this region. Other way, the temperature, increasing temperature, reduces the total production of corn and soybean and all that. So what happened? How climate change impact the world as a whole? World as a whole, climate change has an impact. It reduces the groundwater recharge. It reduces the production, and it increases the growth of pest. We know we are now our fear of virus. So the different vector-borne diseases and other viruses, they are, and pollen are increasing, and pollution is increasing, which results the health, which threats in our health. And most important thing is it reduces the agricultural crop production, which results to the hunger, which results to the deficiency of food, or which threat the food security, especially in the country like India, where we where people, most of the people depend on agriculture. This is the situation of the flood. I must say that if the temperature rises, there are the crop disease. There are different types of crop disease. How can I get these the picture from the crop disease? I will give you some idea about the mobile apps latest. And these are the productions, the corn, but they are attacked by disease, and they are main staple food. But she is looking that it is, there are disease in the leaves and all that, which threaten there are actually threaten their food security. Now I concentrate on the Amphan and livelihood, because we discuss the global and in some aspects also Indian aspects of climate change. But now I must concentrate of one incident, that is Amphan, which is the recent phenomena of tropical cyclone, and also affect our country or our area or our district, means West Bengal, Sundarbun. So this is the most important thing. We know, we feel proud of Sundarbun. It is a mangrove vegetation area, and it is there are salt tolerant trees which are called halophytes, and these are the storage of carbon dioxide. Mangrove forest is the storage of carbon dioxide, because it absorbs carbon dioxide from atmosphere, and so it absorbs, and it maintains the balance of the atmosphere. So mangrove forest move carbon dioxide from the atmosphere into the long-term storage in greater quantities than other forests. So it has a very important role, and we know that we are the people who are fortunate, who are very, we live very near to these areas where flora and fauna are of diversified flora and fauna are there. Now I have seen that the coastal area, it is very, very known to all. I collect it from Google Earth, and Google Earth, every people we know, we can even point out our any location our house or our school, college or everything on Google Earth. So it is the mangrove which protect the coast from tropical storm. This is again this amphoon, attack of amphoon. It is also again a mangrove protects the coastal areas, and it is proved that mangroves protect the coast from tropical storm. This was the data. This is a satellite data. It's a Sentinel data. It is 16th May. 16th May, it is pre-amphoon period. We know this is Sagar Island. It is very known. That's why I cropped this part. This is Sagar Island and the other part. So this pre-amphoon period, it is the color is, it is a radar image. So the color is, it shows green, yellow is green. And this part is more green because this is reserve forest areas. And these somewhere there are some water bodies, but most of the colors are green and yellowish green. And this is the river which color shows the blue. So, and this is Bay of Bengal. It is only 16th May. If we go from 16th May to 22nd May, we know that 20th May it hit the coastal areas or Sundarban areas. Amphan hits the Sundarban areas of West Bengal just after 4 days. All these islands are covered by water. Due to surging of the ocean water, not only in the coastal part, but also to within these creeks and channels and rivers, these areas, you see that the water surging affected up to Hingalganj. So, hello, am I audible? Hello?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay. So I must explain why this tropical cyclone occurs and what is its shape and its shape of the cyclonic structure of the Amphan. All tropical cyclones are like that. There is a low in the center. There is the lowest temperature, and the wind comes around the surrounding areas. It started whirling, and these whirling motion causes a huge situation means surrounding and destruction of the houses and trees also. Wind speed, I just give 100 years of wind speed of tropical cyclone in Bay of Bengal for last 100 years. 1900, the wind speed of the tropical cyclone was 45 kilometer per hour. 1910, 64. 20, 64, 34, 64, 1960, 65, 45 to 65, 20 kilometer per hour increased by 60 years. Then 1970, 72, if I go 1988, next 20 years, then it's 65 to 110. So it increases nearly 40 kilometer per hour from then, or 80 kilometer from here to here. Now, if we go to 1999, it is 140, and Amphoon, we know it is 155 to 160-65 kilometer per hour. This is the situation. So why this situation occurs? Why this situation occurs? The temperature, the wind speed of this, when the wind speed of tropical cyclone increases, it becomes destructive, more destructive. So if we see, this is the probable inundation extent within 5 meter storm surge. This is Sagar Island. This is Kolkata. This is Hingalganj here, Bushirhat. Is this green line? This is the track of super cyclone Amphan. This is the track of the eye of the Amphan is was moving along this line, and from this line 5 kilometer right
and 5 kilometers left or east and west. These are the highly affected area. Next, if we get to 10 kilometers from this line, 10 kilometers purple color and 10 kilometers this side, we know what happened in Kolkata. 5,000 trees uprooted and the green Calcutta, it was not at all green, it was partly green, but that partly green Calcutta become now the devoid of green, greenness. So greenness is necessary for the human being. Greenness is necessary for the comfortable living. So it occurs here. And next, when we see that this surging of the water, surging it 5 meter high. 5 meter high water in the surges here, and this red color, it is 5 meter, 4.5 meters. So the huge height of this salt water submerged the coastal areas. And you see, this is Sagar Island. I make reference of this Sagar Island. And what happened? When these region submerged under the salty water, it not only it damaged the crop of this year, but it damaged the crop of the 2 to 3, 4 years, means up to 2 to 3, 4 years, because it takes 3, 4 years or 5 years to wash this salt cover for each and every monsoon season. After Ayla, people started to migrate. People of that region, coastal region, started to migrate because that surging of the salty water causes the soil salty, resulting the salty soil, which is not suitable for agriculture. And it is possible, agriculture is possible in salty water soil, but the seeds are very costly and they are not habituated of they don't have such big money or fund for getting those separate type of special type of seeds. So they left the land, and not only that, they left, they leave the village for getting job in other cities. So now we will discuss that what is the situation in 1970 to starting from 1970, we know different names which sometimes strike Bangladesh, sometimes here the Ayla, then there are super cyclone Amphan, and before super cyclone Amphan there are Bulbul. So there are many super cyclone. Why? That the temperature, the central part or the central part of the storm, the temperature goes down. It was in 1970 when Bhola super cyclone occurred. It was 966 millibar, whereas now in case Amphan, the low pressure in the center was 925 millibar. So 966 to 925, 40 millibar. It results a huge withdrawal of wind from surrounding areas. It results a extreme type of wind circulation because of the land heating. The hotter the land, the lower the temperature. The hotter the land, the higher the temperature, the lower the pressure. Joto ushnota barbe, toto ta chap ta kombe, bayu chap kombe. So the lower the pressure, joto chap kombe, toto charidik theke beshi batash ute ashbe. And not only that, the speed of the wind is more and more, means higher and higher. Joto beshi chute aste thakbe, joto center e low pressure dike, তো তার লো প্রেশার যদি 970 মিলিবার হয় সে ইট ইফ ইট ইজ গোজ ডাউন টু 920 অর 25 মিলিবার দেন ইট কজেড ফোর টাইমস ফাইভ টাইমস স্পিড অফ দ্য উইন্ড সো ইট কজেস আ ডিভাস্টেটিং সাইক্লোন দিস ইজ দ্য রেজাল্ট অ্যাকচুয়ালি স্টর্ম হাইট ইট সার্জেস 6 to 7 meters, sometimes 5 to 7 meters, 5 to 6 meters. But the speed of the wind is, when the speed of the wind is very high, it results in surging of the ocean water into the land. So it is the temperature rise not only affects the people comfort zone, not only affects the agriculture, also affects the coastal areas. Huge coastal cities are now at vulnerable stage. Huge coastal cities are at risk zone. And climate change, it contributes the increasing frequency of extreme type of weather. Temperature in some places, temperature is higher, getting higher and higher, and it results, especially in tropical region, it results cyclone like Amphan. These are the pictures where sometimes we get. This is Kolkata. This is Hingalganj, and people they are confined not only due to COVID-19 but also Amphan. And this is the picture is very, very significant to us because this is a way for the ferry ghat, and all are submerged, all were submerged. It means the communication system totally collapsed. They didn't have any way to move from one place to another, and they are confined to other in some places. Now, this thing, Dr. Vidisha Ghosh Dostidar, she mentioned that rising ocean temperature. You see that rising ocean temperature, the temperature from 1880 to 2020, it becomes one degree. It means it is a very, very important thing. If the temperature is 28 degree Celsius on the ocean bodies, it creates the cyclone. This is the Bay of Bengal. This is the shape of the Bay of Bengal, and Bay of Bengal from here, cyclones move in this way sometimes in this way, and also sometimes it hits Orissa, here it hits Kolkata and Bangladesh, here it hits Tamil Nadu, and like that. So in different seasons, it hits not only Kolkata, but also eastern part of different parts of the eastern coast of that. Not only eastern coast, we know that now Mumbai is suffering from flood, and especially Mumbai, it is a highly urbanized area, highly urbanized Mumbai city. And it is on the just on the Arabian coast, and its height is only 1 to 2 meter most of the part from the sea level. And when cyclonic storm and with huge high rainfall, huge amount of rainfall occurs, then the city. Just the city life stopped. It causes, there is many causes, there are many causes for water logging in Mumbai. It is there are the many flaws in planning. Nowadays, I must say that there are some data fatality. In 1970, when Bhola super cyclone occurred, the fatality was 3 lakhs to 5 lakhs. But now in super cyclone Amphan, Now we know that it is only 118 casualties. This is the actually one thing we can say that we are getting advantage of the technology, and there are satellite, and these satellite are tracking the atmospheric condition, ocean condition, land conditions, and everything. So they are giving, we are collecting data from the satellite, and these satellite data are run through mathematical models. So we are getting correct data or correct prediction of the cyclone or other things. So people, especially fishermen or the people who are living on the in the villages on the side of the coastal areas, on so they people government announced several times, and they help them to shift the people from there to higher land. So this is the cause. These results are less damage, and not only that, it is airborne Doppler. Means we know that this is these are used for aerial survey. These drone not only used for mapping and from which the damage can be assessed. And so we first thing is with the help of images, analysis of images, early warning system is now working. Demarcation of vulnerable areas are also demarcated. Relief preparedness mostly is there by government agencies and non-government agencies, especially regarding drinking water, especially regarding the restoration of damage, and also the construction of cyclone shelter. Cyclone shelter are used for that. We know there are some cyclone shelter. I went in one college where there is a cyclone center in Hingalganj area. So there are also, there are educational awareness, there are some coordination committee to work with the sufferer and with the other places. And this in this way, 3 lakhs to 5 lakhs life damage are reduced to 118. So this is one thing. But If the people get relief from the cyclone, they are able to survive, but they need the livelihood. The important thing is when the temperature, not only the temperature and the climate change. In case of Sundarban, only mangrove vegetation can protect the soil or the erosion of the coastal region. It can only hold the soil. It can only protect the land from huge cyclone. So if the people, save people from the different types of disasters, especially with the prediction, good prediction of flooding or prediction of cyclone or drought and everything. But there are they become highly marginalized because they usually they have low health status, low income, low educational status, low, and also suffering from different disease because they don't have money to do their checkup or like that for healthy situation. And not only that, they with the changing situation, that with the changing temperature, with the changing water conditions, there is a necessity of changes the agriculture also. They should coagulate the understanding of climate change. Means climate change ta ke thik moto bujhte hobe je if we know that from our elderly people, from our parents, we come to know that rainy season, now the rainy season is 2 months later from the previous time. আগে যে সময়ে বর্ষা আরম্ভ হতো এখন দু মাস পিছিয়ে যাচ্ছে. So this is a situation, and people have to adapt. They have to know they have to collect the information when monsoon strike the land, when seedlings will grow, when they will get good amount of rainfall. So these are the knowledge people need to have for with the changing climatic conditions. Actually, there are some varieties of crops which cannot grow or which cannot produce their crops with increasing temperature. I know about coffee. There are coffee cultivation. With the increase of 2 degrees temperature, the coffee production reduces by 33%. So slash down of 33% production, the cost of production goes up because the labor charges are there, because the fertilizer are there, seeds are there, everything is there. So the production cost will go high. And when the production cost will go high, we the people who buy that coffee or teas or tea or other products, which we will pay more. So this is the situation. But the research is going on that if the temperature is 2 degrees higher, the seeds can bear that. The production will not be reduced by 33%. It may reduce by 5% or like that. So the research is going on to adjust the climatic changes. If we see that we can get carrots and cauliflowers and capsicum now fresh from farm, and it is the different types of seeds which are practiced in agricultural universities, that they produce in comparatively higher temperature also, because it has a demand throughout the year. So with the higher temperature, these seeds can be cultivated. So they have to know about that, the climate change, storm surge height, elevation above mean sea level, drainage proximity, slope, land use change, and even tourism. Sometimes tourism may cause the hazard in climatic condition, land use condition, and also they should have alternative arrangement. So why I use one word, refugee? Well, who is refugee? One who flees for refuge or safety. Ekjon je tar safety er jonno kono jayga chhere chole jay. According to Webster dictionary, ekti manush যদি একটা জায়গা ছেড়ে তার সেফটির জন্য চলে যায় তখন তাকে রিফিউজ বলা হয়. সেখানে আর ইনহাবিটেন্টস অফ সুন্দরবন নাও ক্লাইমেট রিফিউজিস অর এনভায়রনমেন্টাল রিফিউজিস. এখন কি সুন্দরবনের লোকেরা যতই আস্তে আস্তে ওয়াটার লেভেলটা উঠে যাবে, যত মৌসুমি আইল্যান্ডস, আই উই নো দ্যাট মৌসুমি আইল্যান্ড ইজ ইনান্ডেটেড ইন দিস আমফুন. সো এইভাবে একটা একটা করে দ্বীপ যদি ডুবে যায়, তো ফর গেটিং সেফটি পিপল will leave that island and they become refugee. So this is a most important thing that we must take care of. And here I say about that, for livelihood we will adjust ourselves. And I say some things that I already mentioned about thus satellite, and this is a GPS. And this one is satellite, and this is a GPS, and these satellites we are giving. There are many sensors. They are giving information on soil and water conditions, temperature, surface temperature, and also there are these GPS. From here we are getting the field data. We're standing on the field, we will get many XYZ values, and means latitude, longitude, and the conditions of the land use can be extracted from the satellite images. And if we use these, we can make a smart agriculture. What is smart? Who is smart? যে একটা যে কোনো সিচুয়েশনকে ঠিক করে হ্যান্ডেল করতে পারে সেই স্মার্ট। সো স্মার্ট ফার্মিং ইজ আ ম্যানেজমেন্ট কনসেপ্ট ফোকাসড অন প্রোভাইডিং দ্য এগ্রিকালচারাল ইন্ডাস্ট্রি উইথ দ্য ইনফ্রাস্ট্রাকচার টু লেভারেজ অ্যাডভান্স টেকনোলজি। অ্যাডভান্স টেকনোলজি নিয়ে যদি আমরা এগ্রিকালচারাল লসটাকে কমাতে পারি, যদি আমরা এগ্রিকালচারটাকে একটা মানে আমাদের মেনটেন করে দিতে পারি, মানে কোন রকমেও হ্যাজার্ড গুলোকে আমরা ট্যাকল করতে পারি, আমরা হ্যাজার্ড গুলোর সঙ্গে নিজেরা অ্যাডজাস্ট করে নিতে পারি, তাহলে সেই জায়গাটাকেই আমরা বলবো স্মার্ট এগ্রিকালচার। তাই স্মার্ট এগ্রিকালচার করার জন্য হোয়াট ডু উই নিড দ্য information beforehand. We need the information about the soil, about water, about weather, temperature, rainfall, everything. So we can use the data. So I just give you that these are the temperature, these are the mobile apps. You can download it not only for agriculture but also for your situation or condition. You see that it is air visual, air. I just captured it. It is now at Rabindra Bharati University near. It is moderate, and now Kolkata is good. It is dated, I think, just 5th or 4th of August. So these are the, now we know that due to lockdown, the carbon emission is comparatively lower. So the air aerosols, which causes the pollution, is also lower, and it comes under moderate, because most of the time if we get the data of 1 year or 2 years back when the situation was normal, not new normal, normal, so that time the near Rabindra Bharati or near Kolkata station, Kolkata, it shows the red color, means it is not good for health, not good for people health. So this is a situation. We can get information about temperature, about rainfall, about cloudy conditions, and also wind speed from bathymeter, weather and radar. It gives you the regular at temperature at regular time. It is at 15 17 means 17 18 19 20 means we get past ta 6 ta 7 ta etc. So eibhabe we can get the temperature, rainfall, and also wind speed, and also pollen grains and pollution, and air visual for air quality. So these are useful, and now we are going for the support from agricultural support from the real time support using these the mobile apps. I am actually try to say that climate is changing due to urbanization, due to industrialization. We cannot say that we will not use fan or air condition because it creates pollution. Because when thermal power generated using the burning of coal, it creates ash, it creates aerosol in the air, it creates pollution. So we will not use fan, we will not use air conditioner. No, we cannot say that. When you go forwards, we cannot come backwards. We may say that we should use alternative energy sources in solar power. So using solar power, resulting the lesser use of coal for thermal power. So if we use wind power, solar power, these are non-conventional energy sources. So these powers, these are very useful because we will burn less amount of coal. And these not only these helps us to get the reserve, coal reserve intact, and also we maintain our control our air quality, so air pollution. So these, we need a long way. Gradually, our country is going towards wind power. We know in Tamil Nadu, in Rajasthan, Gujarat, especially Gujarat, wind power system. And now in our city, also solar panel are also installed over many colleges and many new buildings. Also, roof gardening is encouraged for because from roof garden, the absorption of heat by the building is lesser and it doesn't create microclimate. It helps to get a good, healthier climatic conditions. So, in the very small steps, we can go forward for tackling these climatic change or these the adverse reactions or adverse conditions of the climate change. From Kyoto Protocol in 1992, it's the whole world started to blame each other. Someone are saying that these countries are producing more carbon dioxide. Others are saying that they are producing more carbon dioxide. So these are happens. These are happens. We know that people, human beings are doing this. But our motto is to get to adjust this situation, the adverse situation, and to maintain our agricultural production at least for roti, kapda, aur makan. At least for the now in this lockdown condition, the most of the industries are closed, but most of the people who are getting food only due to the agricultural crops which are produced by our farmers' brothers. So farmers' brothers and sisters, they are doing a lot. They produce, and if there are adverse situation going on in the due to climate change, it is necessary to train them how to adjust this adverse situation, because it may take 50 years or 100 years to control the situation. Whether it will be controlled or not, I don't know. Whether the climatic conditions, the pollution will be controlled or not, I don't know. But I may say that we will work for our farmer brothers. We will give them some help for better production. So we will live. We can survive. That's why with climate change, I use this one. Please see, this is plant identification with the flowers, leaves, and I go fast because I take a lot of time. So I must finish that plant nurturing. So there is the nutrient, disease, and methods. How can you nurture these plants? How can you, what type of nutrients or the fertilizer, biofertilizer will be giving by you? That is a Plantix. This is one app. And another is the identification of the disease. What types of disease are there? Some disease, some plants are not identified. This is jute plant. We take this data from the field. Because we are doing a small experiment in Jangal Mahal area, so these are from our team, and they can identify the disease. And if you post it, you can get the suggestion for that. And these are the specification of leaves. These are actually leaves, and these are called actually mombin, means amra gachir pata. এবং এইগুলো আমরা আইডেন্টিফাই করতে পারবো অনেক সময় অনেক জায়গায় এবং কোনো অসুখ কোনো ডিজিজ হলে সেটাও আইডেন্টিফাই করা যায় এবং এই যে দিস ইজ দ্য রেজাল্টস অফ লেডিস ফিঙ্গার মিন্স ঢ্যাঁড়স গাছে বা অনেক সময় ব্রিঞ্জাল বেগুন গাছে যে সমস্ত পাতায় এই যে দিজ আর দ্য পেস্ট দ্য বিটল কোনটা বিটল দিজ আর ইফ ইউ গেট আ স্ন্যাপশট অ্যান্ড ইউ সেন্ড ইট টু দেম they will say that what types of pests are these pests are and what will you do. This is a papaya tree. It is also pest attack. These are virus attack. And beans looks healthy. So there are different types of snapshot of the field, and you can get the idea. And if there is a crop doctor, it is also an application. You can log in, and there are various languages. You explore this, and it is you can get help from nearest Krishi Vikas Kendra and expert advice on actually online. And these are for rice, how to get the production. All these are the mobile apps, Plantix, Leaf, and this Doctor, Plantix, and these are many apps are there. Some of them I mentioned here because I think that the situation we plant nurturing, these are all done by with the help of the mobile apps. And this is also there, mobile apps, different mobile apps. This is the Leaf Snap apps. If you give the Leaf Snap, you will get the idea of the which type of that. So I must say that we should discuss about the climatic conditions, the causes of climate change, the results of climate change, the effects of climate change. How can we, how much we are vulnerable, how much, what is our risk index, what is our discomfort index. But at the same time, as when we feel discomfort, we need electric fan or air conditioner or air cooler. So I think that we should think about the alternative or the supportive support for the agriculture in the climate change condition. So these are this is my just opinion. Thank you all. This is a situation when we are most, I must say, that all stay safe, stay home here. So this, I just complete my takes a lot of time. So thank you all.
Thank you, madam, for delivering such an insightful and enriching lecture. Thank you so much, madam. Feedback link has been posted in the chat box. Please fill it up to get a certificate which are auto-generated. Now, we are starting our interactive session. This session is conducted by Ms. Bonnishikha De. Now, it's over to Ms. Bonnishikha De.
Good evening, everyone. I am Bonnishikha De, Department of Geography, Kanipur Mohila Mahavidyalaya. Now I am going to start the interaction session of this webinar. So the first question is from Mr. Konad Ghosh. Why have Kolkata shown a decrease in the number of hot days while all other states the number of hot days increased?
No, not Kolkata shows not the rate of hotter days is lesser than Chennai, not decreasing. It is lesser. Lesser means that days, the hotter days in Chennai is much more than Kolkata. But then in Kolkata, it is also hotter, but it is due to, I think, still Kolkata, Chennai, 60% of water bodies are actually transformed into cities or I think highways. That's why the temperature or the temperature is higher. And also I must say that usually Chennai is hotter than Kolkata because it is that the latitude is nearing to equator only. I think it is 12 degrees. I think so. So these are the causes, but the Kolkata is also getting hotter. At a comparatively means slower pace till now. Hello.
Thank you, ma'am. And the next question is from Dr. Tapan Kumar Das. why the speed of cyclone increased many fold from 45 to 155 per hour in the course of only 120 years. May I know the source of the data, please?
Source of database is there. It is from Indian Meteorological Department. I collected this data and you will get it in Indian Meteorological Department site. And the most important thing is I have already mentioned that with increasing temperature, not only on the land surface, but also on the water surface, the temperature increases and it intensifies the formation of the low pressure. I at the same time mentioned that that was a 966 millibar in 1900. Means 100 bochor age it was chilo 966 millibar, whereas now it comes down to 925 millibar. So the fall of pressure, the lower the pressure, the higher the wind speed. We know it. Joto beshi temperature bade pressure ta toto kome jabe central part e, and it becomes a huge trough like. Eta ekta trough er moto hoye jabe and surrounding region theke tokhon faster rate at higher speed e. এই বাতাস আর উইন্ড ছুটে আসবে এবং ইট ক্রিয়েটস আ হুইরলিং মোশন সো ইন দি অনলি উইদিন দিস 30 ইয়ার্স অফ 40 ইয়ার্স দ্য টেম্পারেচার রাইজেস মোর দ্য প্রেশার বিকামস লোয়ার এন্ড লোয়ার এন্ড ইট কজেস আ স্পিডি উইন্ড মোশন অর দ্য সাইক্লোন ফর্মেশন অফ সাইক্লোন উইথ হায়ার স্পিড.
Thank you, ma'am. And the next and last question is from Mr. Shubhankar Naha. How can we get the data of local weather condition, amount of rainfall, temperature, etc.?
I give you some mobile apps, and I already, if it is recorded, you will get it. There are some mobile apps. You just make it on and you will get data. Just make it on where you are. You are in Delhi or Mumbai, or if it is it shows a GPS location where it is, the temperature, rainfall, humidity, wind speed. These four data you can get from mobile apps. It is mentioned there that including pollution level, including air quality, breezometer, and temperature, rainfall, you can get only from your Android phone.
Thank you, ma'am, to respond of all the queries have for you. Now I will request Ms. Laboni Sarkar for the valedictory speech. Over to you, Laboni.
Honorable dignitaries, distinguished guests, respected principal madam, and dear participants, on behalf of Banipur Mohila Mahavidyalaya and the organizing committee, I feel an immense pleasure to take this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks of our eminent speaker, Dr. Shukla Hazra, principal of East Calcutta Girls College, who spared the time from her busy schedule to grace the webinar, which is extremely relevant address on climate change and amphun in contemporary scenario. Now, I take this opportunity specially express my deep regards and gratitude to our respected principal madam, Dr. Bidisha Ghosh Dostidar, Panipur Mohila Mahavidyalaya, for always encouraging us and providing opportunities to organize such event. Thank you, madam. I would further extend a heartiest thanks to Professor Moha Basu, madam, coordinator of IQAC, who always stands by our side to give us every sort of help and confidence in us. Thank you, madam. My sincere gratitude also goes to convener of webinar subcommittee, Professor Rima Kanjilal, madam, for always encouraging and providing support. Thank you, madam. I would like to thank and sincere gratitude to the technical team of our college who helped us to organize this webinar successfully. My deep sense of appreciation and thank you to all participants who chose to be live with us and attend the webinar with great enthusiasm and made successful event. Lastly, I would like to thank and sincere gratitude to all our faculty members and non-teaching staff who always give their every support and help. Once again, I thank you all for being with us this evening. Have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you. Now, I request Ms. Bonishikha De to take over the session for informal ending of the webinar. Thank you, and over to you, Ms. Bonishikha De.
Now, this is the ending session of the webinar. I would like to thank our principal, ma'am, Dr. Vidisha Ghosidhar, our IQC coordinator, Mrs. Mohua Basu, and our webinar subcommittee member, Mrs. Rima Kanchilal, to arrange the webinar. And thank you all the faculty members of our college for their support and help. A big thanks to our resource person, Dr. Shukla Hajra, for her precious speech. And thank to all the all present in this webinar and make it successful. We get successful. Thank you. Stay safe and healthy. Good night.
Thank you all. Thank you. Thank you, Vidisha. Thank you all teachers and students and all others. So it is very, I am very glad to join you, and it is my privilege to meet you with such august audience. There are many people who join this seminar, and I get opportunity to share my thought process to other people. So thank you especially to Dr. Vidisha Ghosidhar for inviting me to here to say something on this webinar. So I'm leaving. I'm leave kochi. Vidisha, I'm leave kochi. I'm leaving. Okay.